East Carolina dismissed Mike Houston over the weekend. This is my alma mater. I went to East Carolina. And there are two obvious choices to replace Mike Houston and become the Pirates' next head coach. The coaching search can't really begin in earnest until teams start finishing up their season, their seasons. But there are two obvious choices that come to mind with the Pirates' next head coach. Before we get into the names, let's dig into the criteria. The Pirates are looking for the inverse of the man they fired, Mike Houston. We talk about this anytime there's a coach opening, that usually when you're trying to replace somebody that you fired, you want to find somebody that is the inverse of what you just let go. It might happen in your office. If somebody's incredibly lazy in your office and disorganized, don't be surprised when the guy who used to be in the military is now in your office and is punctual and there 5 minutes early and is incredibly buttoned up. Generally, you want to hire what the opposite of what you fired was. So what was Mike Houston? Defensive-minded head coach, had a lot of his success at an FCS powerhouse. JMU was in FCS then when he won a national championship. Now they're, of course, in the Sun Belt. So the inverse of that is a coach with offensive background, probably a coordinator, probably younger, definitely from the FBS ranks. The two names that stand out, Clemson offensive coordinator Garrett Riley is the first name that comes to mind. He's Lincoln Riley's younger brother. He was at ECU for 3 years. He was a GA there. He was an outside receivers coach. Spent time at App too, so similar program in the state of North Carolina. Had success there. Has familiarity with the region, with what he's doing at Clemson. Speaking of that, since leaving the Carolinas, or the state of North Carolina, Garrett helped lead TCU to a national championship appearance a couple years back. And now at Clemson has completely transformed the Tigers' offense. They've scored 40-plus in 5 of their 7 games this year. Last year, when they had that 5-game winning streak at the end of the season, in 4 of those games, they scored more than 30 points. Not something we saw under DJ Uiagalelei when he was playing. So Garrett Riley is going to be a top candidate for that job. The other one that comes to mind is LSU OC Joe Sloan. He should get serious consideration because he played at ECU. And he did so during one of the best seasons of Pirate football over the last quarter century, since the 90s. 2008, they were ranked in the top 25. They won the Conference USA championship under Skip Pultz. He was a backup quarterback on that team. What is he doing now? Well, last year, he was Jaden Daniels' quarterback coach at LSU. That coordinator then left, OC there, left to go to Notre Dame. And stepping into the offensive coordinator shoes, Garrett Nussmeier's humming, and LSU is a top 10 team right now. So that would make some sense, too. You'd probably want more Group of 5 experience for him on his resume, but the ECU ties are strong. Two other suggestions that I've seen that I like a lot, Holton Ahlers has suggested from the Holton Ahlers show, former Pirate quarterback who played for Mike Houston. Dwayne Ledford, who's the run game coordinator for the Atlanta Falcons right now, coached at NC State, was an offensive line coach there. Scott Satterfield coached under him at App State, joined Scott at Louisville, was his offensive coordinator when they had a good season there, 8-5. He's been all over the state. NFL, college experience at this level, highest level. He's done so much, and he played at ECU as well in the 90s under Steve Logan. That would make some sense. And then Bruce Feldman was suggesting some names. Now, there are some that I don't like. Get Jay Bateman's name out of here. Unbelievable. You're going to hire another defensive-minded coach, and the guy who stole plays from Wake, one of the guys in Wakey Leaks? Come on. On top of that, he couldn't stop anything as North Carolina's defensive coordinator under Mack Brown 2.0. So get that name out of here. One that I actually liked came from Bruce Feldman, who I respect a lot, from The Athletic, one of college football's top reporters. He suggested Miami offensive coordinator Shannon Dawson. Now, what are his bona fides? Well, look at Miami's offense this year. Okay, well, that's good. What are his ties to the area? He's 47 years old. His coaching career began in North Carolina at D2 Wingate. And this might be the most important part of the resume. John Gilbert, the ECU AD that, you know, it's been there for the last 5-6 years now. He was at Southern Miss prior to going to Greenville America. That's also where Shannon Dawson came from. So there is some familiarity there. He's one of the top assistants in college football, going to be a candidate for the Broyles Award handed out to the top assistant coach. So one of those four names I'd absolutely love. If it were Garrett Riley at Clemson, Joe Sloan at LSU, Dwayne Ledford at the Atlanta Falcons right now, and even Shannon Dawson from the Miami Hurricanes. Anything outside of that, you're taking some levels of risk, but hopefully it's still offensive background and an inverse of what they had before under Mike Houston.